And welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. First of all, I wish you a happy new year 2020. I hope you had a good start. And I thought about what puzzle could I show first in the new year. And due to the name of this one, I picked this one because it's called the Confetti Box. It's a puzzle box that needs to be opened. Was designed last year by Eric Fuller from the US and also crafted by Cubic Dissection. I think there are still some available. I put your link in the description where you can check it out. And if you look at this puzzle, it looks incredibly interesting, incredibly well made. The outer frame here is made out of canary wood, and you can see beside all these different brown shades, it also has some nice, interesting looking reddish colors here inside. The inner frame here is made out of padauk, and you can see this glowing reddish orange like color, which always looks insane. And then we have also this centerpiece here, which is made from spalted tamarino. And these combinations of these three different kinds of wood, from my point of view, is an excellent choice and looks just stunning. The quality, as usual for Cubic Dissection, is perfect. Very tight tolerancing. There are also some metal pieces I can see down here. And also it seems there are some magnets involved. So I'm interested to see how the thing will open up and if I will be able to make it. But also, I'm curious why the thing is called Confetti Box, and I think we should just go on and find out after the spoiler break. Regarding the difficulty, I have no idea how difficult this puzzle really is. We will just find out, I hope, today. So let's have a closer look and see what we can discover. So this thing here is definitely loose, so you can hear it has some slight free play here in this direction. Also, there's some free play in Y direction. And if you look inside here in these two holes on the sides, we can see that there's some small metal pins or something inside. And there's a hole here on the top, but there's nothing visible inside. There's a magnet here on the bottom side, and there's also this pin here, this pin, or how it looks like. Oh, which can be moved. So I think I can push the thing out. So let me just take this thing out. It's a, oh, there was a noise coming from the inside, and oh, okay, the lid popped up and I pushed it back and it popped up again. Okay, anything special here on this pin? Can I maybe put it inside the hole? No, it's not possible. And whoa, okay, the lid came up a good amount until the top, and it seems the function of the pins here on the two sides is just to guide this compartment up and down, that it slides properly. What is this feature? Okay, this is a magnet, but this is probably only to hold this stick into position. I think there's no other function to this magnet down here. Let's see if there are other magnets maybe inside here. There's also a magnet here inside. And another one here, you can see it. It's probably the magnet that helps to keep the thing in position. You can see as soon as this reaches this position, it will just snap into position. If I look inside here, you probably can't see this, but if I look inside here, I can see something on the bottom of this box. Something is reflecting there, but it's impossible for me to reach it. Can it be maybe twisted? No. It seems the two magnets that are inside are not moving with the box, so there is one down here by the first position of the boxes. And this remains in place actually. You can see it. And there's another one up here which is moving with the box. So two magnets, one here, one here.
Same on the other side, one here and one here. Does it help me? I don't know. Let's put this thing back in. No. So what else can we see on the puzzle? This thing can't be unscrewed. So in the upper compartment here also no magnets. This bottom plate here seems to be fixed and not movable. There is some slight free play here in all directions, but it's also rather thin. You can hear it. It's not as thick as these pieces here, but probably thinner. But it seems to be interfering with this frame, so it will not be movable. Currently, I have no idea how to manage this. I need to correct myself because I think there are some magnets also up here. I think you can feel it. Here you go. Here you go. Now you saw it. There are some magnets here, but not here. And also here. And these magnets, I can imagine, probably holding the lid in place. But how can I remove it? I mean, is there maybe a way I can get this bar inside down here and get it upright and just push it down and this stick will push up the lid? No, this is not possible. Oh, I have an idea. I have an idea. Maybe I can just... No. Let me close the holes down here. No. Oh, of course, I can close it with my fingers. Oh, yes, that's it. Look at this. This is insane. Have you seen this? And here's also the confetti. Happy New Year 2020. No, but seriously, this locking mechanism or opening mechanism is brilliant. Oh my god, this is insane. Look at this. I'm surprised that I was capable to understand how it's really done. And it works the following way. This is the initial condition. Okay. So, you can't get this compartment here out without removing this stick. As soon as you removed it, it will pop out by itself by the slightest movement, as you can see, and you pull it out and you load or you increase the volume, the inner volume of this box by pulling it out. And now if I push it down quickly, the air will escape through this hole and through these holes down here. As you can see, if I close this hole here with my finger and push it down, you can see the confetti will be blown away. Yeah, not sure what this hole here is for actually, if this is really necessary to make it work more reliable. I can imagine yes, otherwise there would be no need to have this hole except to confuse the puzzler. If I close these two holes now down here with my finger and push it down, okay, this was too slow. And you can hear also the airflow going through the gaps here. And of course it's required to make this puzzle in a tight tolerancing to make this work. So let's try it again. Okay, this time I did it a little bit faster and the lid pops out. And this works, it seems to work pretty reliable. Let me try again, load it. Okay, Very, very cool design from my point of view. Very unique. Personally, I haven't seen any solution like this before. And this makes it even cooler, of course. I can say absolutely unexpected solution from my side. Puzzle closed again. And that was the confetti box. I wish you again a happy and successful year 2020. There will be also some interesting things happening in 2020 to this channel here on YouTube, also on Facebook. So if you're not following already on Facebook, just be sure to also subscribe to my Facebook channel. And there will also maybe happening some cool things that are related to puzzling, but beside of the YouTube channel here, Mr. Puzzle. So just stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't, and until next time, keep on puzzling.